Please stand.
Amen.
save us, and he descended to the realm of the dead. By his resurrection he gave joy to his disciples, and gave light to the nations with the light of his salvation. To the good one be glory and honor on this blessed Sunday, and all the days of our lives and forever.
Thank you. Glory to the Lord, all of the apostles. May the mercy of God descend upon the reader and the listeners, and upon his parishioner children forever.
Brothers and sisters, so he came and proclaimed peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him, both of us have access in one spirit to the Father. So then you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are citizens with the saints, and also members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Jesus Christ himself as the cornerstone. In him, the whole structure is joined together and grows into a holy temple in the Lord, in whom you are also built together spiritually, into a dwelling place for God. Praise be to Yahweh.
In this gospel, there is a variety of ways that I'm sure when it was happening, that there were several opinions and ideas and discussions about what was going on. For those who knew that it was Zacchaeus, and that he was a tax collector, and that he was rich, they probably were thinking, what is wrong with this man? He's gone crazy. I mean, how many grown men climb up into a sycamore tree? And besides, what is he up to? I'm sure some people thought that his plans were an alternative and did not think highly of this. Probably every thought that anybody would have when you have a gathering of people, those who are critical and judgmental, I'm sure were being critical and judgmental and coming up with all kinds of theories and what's going wrong here. Those who have trouble believing that Jesus can do what people have been saying he can do, were watching with a mind set on trying to discount anything and everything that he has to say. The scriptures say they were grumbling. Now I'm thankful that nobody at St. Joseph's ever grumbled, so you'll have to just use your imagination. But I would say that yes, I do grumble about certain things. I think it's the human thing that doesn't justify it. It doesn't give an explanation that Jesus is probably satisfied with. But Jesus isn't looking for the people who are absolutely perfect, that have never done anything that anyone would ever criticize. It says at the end that he was looking for people who were lost, people who were not saved, people who were not living a life that would reflect who Jesus Christ is. Now, Jesus didn't say to him when he found him, and did you notice that he found him where he was at? He didn't wait till Zacchaeus looked more reasonable, probably looked like an idiot up there. He had to admit that he was short of stature. It's a very powerful way that when Jesus finds us, he can find us anywhere. Maybe not in a tree, but maybe in an embarrassing situation. Maybe in a situation that he might want to rationalize and give excuses for how he is living his life. Jesus didn't tell him, you better quit being a tax collector. And he didn't tell him, you better not be rich anymore. In fact, a person who is in a situation like a tax collector and who is rich can do incredible things for the Lord. He, by changing Zacchaeus, can change the world around him. What I mean by this is think of all the different ways that maybe we have been, in our phrases, ripped off, felt defrauded, charged too much, been taken advantage of. Who of us would prefer having a tax collector that has not want to be surrounded by honest, compassionate, giving, sacrificial, open, loving, forgiving people, then it is in our interest that they meet Jesus Christ. That maybe our grumbling gets in the way. Maybe our judgments. Maybe our self-centeredness. Maybe our laziness. Maybe our holding on to grudges get in the way of a heart being changed like a tax collector or someone who is rich. This is the benefit of Jesus asking Zacchaeus, come down out of the tree. I want to come into your home. This is the advantages of a man who has heard other people say things about Jesus where they wanted to. He wanted to see him. He wanted to get close to him. Because he understood that Jesus is not like so often religious leaders. The time spent on trying to control, trying to pass judgment, trying to humiliate, trying to embarrass, was not Jesus. He didn't grumble. He called. And because Jesus came into his home, and because Zacchaeus didn't just give lip service, he changed how many people's lives. I don't know what the population was in the area that Zacchaeus collected taxes from, but I can bet you that the ones who had him for his as their tax collector was sure glad it was him and probably not someone else. The people who were struggling to get enough to eat, marginalized, had absolutely nothing, I think they were extremely grateful that Jesus went into a sinner's house. People do get lost. People do need to be rescued. People are broken. People do live in sadness. People do live in utter pain and grief that they do everything they can to hide it from others. We can't always see the scars and the hurt and the pain. And the way to solve this isn't to make people more fearful, more judgmental, more resentful, more critical. But to experience Jesus Christ, who will go in anybody's home, paying no attention to the grumblers, and change. The more we are changed by Jesus, the more the person next to us is changed by Jesus. And the more that we are changed together, the more our community is changed. We can leave everybody out there without knowing him, but expect to be ripped off, manipulated, controlled, charged too much, and be filled with unredemptive hurt. Thank you, Zacchaeus. Thank you for accepting Jesus. Thank you for letting him change your life, because you have changed ours.
Pray for me.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ and his plan of salvation for us, we call upon this offering of those who please God to add them to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered, for Teresa and for Julian on his baptismal day. Remember also those who share with us today in this offering.
Thank you.
language in which Jesus said, "He has saved the lost." Yeah, I'm down. soul from every sin and receive eternal life.
Wow.
We implore you to purify us from every sin and to accept our offering, so that in one spirit we may call upon you, praying.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
But deliver us from every evil, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, with your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of it, and receive the blessing of the Lord.
O Lord, bless your worshippers who bow before you and implore you. Make them worthy of your mercy and forgive their sins, for your almighty and rich in compassion. We raise glory and thanks to you, with your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, be eternal and consubstantial, be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit. Blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by our holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiving blood. And they are convenient to be put to
Again and again, we thank the Lord and we explore to you for giving us survival to eat and having blood to drink. While our above people have mercy on us.
Have mercy on us, O Lord.
O compassion, there's the Lord. O Lord of all people, have mercy on us. You may be seated.
The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the one God.